In today's video, we'll be taking a look at one of the most underrated feeder insects, aphids. They make great feeders for dart frogs and other small animals. They are easy to culture and surprisingly, they usually don't do any harm to any of our vivarium plants, since each aphid species is specialized on only a specific kind of plant. Specifically, I will be showing you how to culture pea aphids, but towards the end of the video, I will also be talking about using various other kinds of aphids from the wild to feed your animals. The life cycle of aphids is actually quite interesting. During the summer, they reproduce to parthenogenesis, so they are all females, and they give birth to live offspring without mating first. The freshly born aphids are essentially just a smaller version of the adults, in contrast to fruit flies which grow through metamorphosis. They reach their adult size after about 4 molts, which takes a little over a week. Once they are mature, they will start giving birth to 4 to 12 nymphs every day and keep doing that until the end of their 30-day long lifespan. However, if the day lengths get shorter, they will start doing things differently. This is because they believe that, well, winter is coming, and to survive the winter, they start producing male and female offspring, and once those breed, they will actually lay eggs that will overwinter. This obviously slows down the production of young aphids, and that's not what we want when we're culturing aphids as feeder insects. However, it's possible to entirely skip this winter phase using artificial light, so they always believe that it's summer, but more on that later. The aphids that I'm keeping are pea aphids, or Acurtosiphon pisum, and as the name implies, they are specialized on pea plants. There are apparently some other plants that they can live on too, but nothing that we normally keep in our vivariums. At first, I was very anxious about them possibly attacking my beloved vivarium plants, but at this point, I have fed my frogs with aphids in pretty much all of my vivariums, which contain more than 100 plant species in total, and they have never started attacking a single plant. To culture pea aphids, you will need these things: a tub or a glass enclosure to keep them in, a light source, plastic cups, potting soil, and some dried peas. I also like to use paper towels, but these are optional. The way you culture the pea aphids is by regularly growing pea plants. The aphids are mostly interested in the very young and weak plants, so you will end up having to plant new ones fairly often. Step 1 is to take some dry peas and put them in water overnight, or at least for a few hours. This step can be skipped, but the peas will grow much faster if you soak them first, since they have to absorb a lot of water before they start growing. Make sure that the peas you get are only dried and not frozen, since the frozen ones won't grow. I use yellow peas, but green ones should work too. After the peas have been re-moisturized, it's time to plant them. I use plastic cups, the same that I use for fruit flies, with around 2 to 3 cm of potting soil at the bottom. Then I lay the peas on top of it and try to distribute them evenly so they cover almost the whole surface without stacking up above the soil. After that, I add just a tiny bit more soil, and then I mist it a bit, so the top of the pea plants are visible and this extra soil that I added ends up around the base of them to keep them from drying out. By now, the peas will be roughly halfway covered with soil. They would also grow just fine if you were to cover them completely instead, but then you will have a bunch of substrate falling out when you tilt the cups to feed your frogs. When you plant the peas in a way so that they are at the top of the substrate layer, like I do, you can almost even hold the cups upside down without any substrate falling out once the plants have grown. I keep the soil moist, but not soaking wet. Next, I put them in this enclosure that I keep the aphids in. I know some people grow the pea plants in a separate place for a few days, so they get some size before getting infested by the aphids, but I just put them here right away and they always grow just fine. The reason I have them in an enclosure isn't really to keep the aphids concealed. They could easily escape from it if they wanted to, but they always stay as long as they have fresh pea plants to live on. However, I still recommend having them in an enclosure or a tub, because there will be a lot of molts, aphid poop, and some dead aphids collecting at the bottom, and I wouldn't want that directly on my shelf. In the enclosure, I also have paper towels on the bottom, which I can easily replace once poop, molts, and dead aphids start to collect on them, without having to wash the entire tank. I just keep my aphids at room temperature, which varies between 20 and 26 degrees Celsius or 68 to 79 degrees Fahrenheit for me. As the pea plants grow, the aphids will suck out all the liquid from them and thus they will need to be watered every now and then, otherwise they will dry out. A friendly piece of advice is that dried up dead pea plants don't smell great, especially not when you sleep in the same room that you're keeping them in, So I recommend keeping them well watered and throwing them out immediately once they start dying. Something extremely important when culturing aphids is to use artificial light during the winter months, at least if you live in a temperate climate. This is not for the sake of the pea plants, it actually has to do with the life cycle of the aphids, as I mentioned earlier in the winter. During the summer, they give birth to live offspring, but right before the winter, they start laying eggs that overwinter and hatch when the spring comes. This is a very smart survival strategy, but it's very inconvenient for you when you want to culture them in large numbers to feed your dart frogs. Since the egg production is triggered by the day lengths getting shorter, you can make them stay in their summer phase for the whole year by giving them 12 to 14 hours of artificial light all year, so they will always think that it's summer. Exactly what kind of light you're using isn't that big of a deal, but any sheep grow light which is somewhat intense should do the trick. I plant new peas every weekend, and I normally do 3 cultures every time, so each row in this enclosure represents 1 week. I have skipped a week on a few occasions, but with 2 weeks in between cultures, they're not that far from drying out if you're unlucky and haven't watered the plants enough. By making 3 new cultures each time, I usually have enough aphids to feed maybe a third of my dart frog collection a few times per week. They're definitely not replacing the fruit flies, but they are decreasing the amount of fruit fly cultures that I have to make. It's also very convenient to always have aphids on hand in case there might be a few days between the generations in your fruit fly cultures. I know that many people struggle to keep their aphids alive for longer periods of time, and it usually comes down to the routine of setting new pea plants. Luckily, due to the fact that the aphids are parthenogenetic, you could keep the culture going as long as you can find a single aphid that's still alive. After about 3 weeks or so, the plants are usually pretty much done for, without any more aphids on them, and at that point, I throw out the plants and the soil, clean up the cup and reuse it for a new culture. In this case, the oldest cultures were still fine and contained some aphids, so I decided to keep them for a few more days before tossing them away, but normally they look a bit worse and are thrown away immediately. To sum up how to culture pea aphids in a single sentence, all you have to do is plant a few peas every week, put them in a suitable place where you keep your aphids, and give them some kind of artificial light on a timer to increase the day length during the winter. That's it. The aphids themselves can be bought from other poison dart frog keepers or ordered through some vivarium related websites. They are not super common, but if you search for a bit, you should be able to find some. If you can find any dart frog keeper who has the aphids, it's usually not that much trouble for them to just make an extra culture for you, even if they don't openly advertise that they sell them. If you know that you're going to buy a culture of aphids, it's good to plant some peas a few days or a week in advance, so you will have some more plants ready for the aphids to move to once their previous plants die. But depending on the age of the culture you get, you might be fine even if you don't have plants ready, as long as you plant some peas really soon after acquiring the culture. To feed your frogs, you can either cut off a few stems and toss in the vivarium, or you could just shake the whole culture a bit. I prefer the latter, since the aphids won't really move around much if they are left on their host plant. Also, if you breathe on the culture, the aphids will feel the carbon dioxide in the air and think that you're a big animal about to take a snack on the pea plants, and as a result, they will actually just let go of the plant and drop down on the ground to avoid following their host plant into your stomach. This might be a good survival strategy to avoid being eaten by wild animals, but it can of course be taken advantage of by us when feeding the frogs. I normally shake the aphids into a cup with some vitamins in it, instead of putting them straight in the vivarium like I did for this video, and if you let the aphids make up a significant portion of the frog's diet, then you should definitely be doing this. Sometimes the frogs don't really like the aphids at first, and they might spit them out or ignore them in the beginning. However, if you keep trying it, they will eventually start to like them. By now, my frogs always go crazy whenever I feed them with aphids. The word on the street is that the nutritional content of aphids is better than that of fruit flies, but I don't have any reliable source for that. I still wouldn't dare completely replace the fruit flies with aphids, and I still think that fruit flies dusted in vitamin supplements are my preferred main dart frog feeders, but aphids are definitely a great and easy way to vary the frog's diet a bit. You can actually feed many other aphid species to dart frogs as well. In the summer, I usually take some aphid-infested twigs from my elder tree to feed them to my dart frogs. We also grow artichokes in our garden, and I've taken aphids from them and fed them to my frogs as well. I always check out the branches I pick to make sure that I don't get any snails or slugs, but aside from that, I don't really worry that much about any guests that might follow me inside. Of course, you shouldn't be giving aphids that feed on poisonous plants to your frogs. And you should also avoid aphids that were collected in places that could have been sprayed with pesticides or near busy roads where the air is polluted. That's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please consider subscribing to the channel because it really helps me out and it's completely free. You can also press the notification bell so you won't miss out on any future uploads. I have some really awesome content planned in the near future. If you want to see more of my animal room, feel free to follow me on Instagram @gecko_geek06. As always, thank you for watching.